Hello and welcome, my honey-smeared leaves. Sinnoh actually has not only a problem when it comes to fire types, but ice as well. Also, except legendaries, there's only one line of dragon types. Sure, dragons are supposed to be rare, but I think we can add some. Let's first delve into the early game, for which I have an idea. While I know people hate the three monkeys with a passion, I like the idea behind them, that they are kind of a second starter. So let's do that. You will get one monkey as a gift, with a type that is good against your rivals. I have a special idea for that, but let's get back to them later. The other idea is some regional forms, but these will also be special. You will encounter them in the wild, but which one you can actually get depends on your starter. If you want the other two, you have to trade with people that chose a different starter than yours. So, if you have chosen Turtwig and your rival Chimchar, then you will encounter Sinnoh Oddish. It will be a grass fire type. Its body will become red and its leaf will look like flames. Or rather, they are leaves, but flames as well. They are hot, but they can use photosynthesis. Sinnoh Gloom will have a mean look and flames coming out of those ball-shaped leaves. The hole in its head will emit sparks instead of stinky, poisonous mist. The final evolution, will it be Vileplume or Bellossom? Well, why not both? I call it Flamancer. It will have a skirt like Bellossom, just more fiery, and its head leaves will look like a flamenco dancer's head. The name comes from flame, flamenco, and dancer. Why has it evolved in such a way? Due to it living between Fluoroma Town and the Fuego Ironworks, they often have caught on fire. Over time, however, they have adapted to the heat, that dryness, and evolved into its regional form. As you can see, there's a specific schematic I am following here. First off, the typing is a combination of your and your rival's starter. Also, it is a branching evolution of a three-stage Pokémon, with the last evolution combining the branches. However, due to availability, I had to tweak that a little, you will see. Also, all three are Kanto Pokémon that got their alternative evolution in Johto. So what if you have chosen Chimchar, giving your rival Piplup? You will be able to catch Sinnoh Slowpoke, a fire water type. When they met Bidoof for the first time and looked into their eyes, they saw it. Something looking as dopey as them. That awakened a fiery fighting spirit in them that turned into actual fire. Well, that is the thing people think happened. In reality, it was because they always fished near the Fuego Ironworks and often got caught on fire, just like the Oddish. However, other than those, they didn't notice it, and so it became part of them somehow. They are also the aforementioned tweak, since they aren't really a three-stage evolution. However, the only other choices would be Wurmple, which splits too soon, and it getting two new evolutions would stand out too much. Ralts, which wouldn't work since Gallade is a Sinnoh Pokémon, and Cosmog, which explains itself. So, I let it evolve into Slowbro, and the final evolution will be a mixture of Slowbro and Slowking. I think that works the best, and adds also the tidbit about being Kantos with new evolutions from Johto. Their body turned blue and they have a burning tail as well as steam coming out of its ears. It's walking around more instead of lying down most of the time. Sinnoh Slowbro still has the steaming ears, but instead of the shell on its tail, it has a whirl of fire. They both have lost their derpy look as well and now look more smug. Also, their fangs are longer. And now for the final evolution, Salsteamer. Salsa, Steam and Dancer. It retains its flaming whirl, on its head is a crown of steam, and the ruff around its neck emits a mist that looks like a flowing dress made out of steam. It is overall a little slimmer and more agile. You have chosen Piplup? Well, this is the final one. Your rival has Turtwig. Then maybe you want a Sinnoh Poliwag. It becomes like this due to it eating special algae, which can only be found in Sinnoh's rivers. These algae have a pretty sharp edge that they will adapt as well. Sinnoh Poliwag is green and its fin has become an algae looking leaf with which it can cut stuff. Its wall pattern is now an actual vine. Poliwhirl retains its tail, it even becomes longer, and the vine as well, of course. It also has a small leaf on its forehead and three buds on each hand. The final evolution will be Swoleafer, a combination of sword dance, leaf and dancer. It has the more agile body of Politoed, but also the stronger arms and legs of Poliwrath. The leaf on its head is now long and kind of feather looking. Its tail has split in two and the buds on its hands became sharp leaf claws. On its belly are four vines that twirl into each other. But what about the aforementioned monkeys and the idea I have for them? Well, I think regional forms aren't really the right way here. But how about some new evolutions for them? Since Sinnoh is all about evolution at a certain place, why not do it for them too? So, where will Simisage evolve? Again, we will go to the Fuego Ironworks, but for a reason. When it levels up there while holding a metal coat, it will evolve into Metasage. The name comes from metal and sage because it gains the steel type. Why steel? Because its design is based on Busozoku, a group of people that are pretty much one with their motorcycle. Metasage has metallic stripes in his hair and metal spikes at the underside of its ears, kinda like earrings. Its eyebrows are more spiky and silver. On top of its hands are metal wheels that it can use to attack, and it has metal wheels on its ankles too, which it can use to move fast. It can still walk, but when he wants speed, he drives. He also can drive on all fours. Its tail emits smoke, like an exhaust pipe. Well, he is still a plant, so that smoke isn't literal smoke, but more like pollen. Its body has an armor made out of bike parts. Cool? Yes. Now on to Simisear. His hairstyle was kinda hard to find out, but I settled for hair metal. Since such an upgoing hairstyle needs a lot of hairspray, which is bad for the environment, he should evolve in a place with such an environment. I think the city is most likely to have a concert in Sinnoh would be Jubilife, so let's have him evolve there. But in a city would be a bit problematic since you would need a rare candy. Well, if they would include some way to battle there, maybe at a later point in the game so you can't evolve it that early, that would work. Also, it has to hold a prism scale to give it that extra fanciness. It will become a glamorous fire poison type. Its hair will sparkle and it has claws with glitter on them. From the fluff around its neck comes a purple coat. Its tail will look like poisonous mist. On to the last one. Simipour, the hippie. Yes, grass type, haha, let's move on. Since making it a water grass type would kinda go against what I'm trying to do, let's go for the other aspect of hippieism, spirituality. Let's make it a psychic type. It evolves on the outside of Mount Coronet, but only on the upper levels, a good, secluded place to meditate. It also has to hold a sachet. It will sit in the lotus pose and actually levitate. Its face has lost the smile, but looks concentrated and calm. It is engulfed in a pink aura and has beads in its hair. In its hands, it holds a purple orb, and on its forehead is a third, open eye. The fur that forms its dress has become longer, more like a robe. Well, do you like them now? I think it would at least make them more interesting. I think two more fire types should do the trick, so let's go! Why not take something from newer generations? I'm thinking about a fire type Wooloo and Dubwool. Wooloo will have a yellow face and red wool. At the ends of its braids are flames. Now, Dubwool should not only be fire. I think Fairy could fit it well, and Fire Fairy is a combination that doesn't exist as of now. Its wool is pink with orange sparks in it. Its horns are covered in flames as well as the grey part of its wool. It has no legs anymore and floats around. The next one I'm thinking of would be Rockruff. However, Rockruff itself should just be what it is. But evolving it into its midday form gives it the ice type. Its fur becomes light blue like snow in the sun, and the spikes around its neck are icicles. Its tail becomes icy mist. Its midnight form will get the fire type. Its fists are covered in flames and its fur is orange. The fur on its back looks like lava. But what about its dusk form? Well, it loses its rock typing and becomes fire ice. The spikes will be icicles and its tail icy mist. The mane will be like lava and its feet are on fire. Its fur is a light purple. With this, we also get some ice types, but I think one more would be good. How about Honedge? Instead of steel, it is ice. Its blade will look like a crystal, but it's actually made out of ice. Its ribbon will be glittery white, like snow. Doublade will not be two swords anymore, but instead one sword with two icy blades. The ribbon will now be tied around the handle. Aegislash will lose its form change ability, but kinda combines both forms. It will be a shield made out of ghostly energy with four icy blades attached to it that it can rotate around. The ribbon is tied around the shield. Okay, let's move on to dragons. I think two will do. The first I think about could be Buffaland. I think its body shape would be kinda like Zygarde's. Its arms has hooves that are kinda claw shaped. Its afro goes down its back like long hair. It has three whip-like tails. It does not have legs. The second one should be a three-stage evolution. Tynamo. It will be an electric dragon. It is green with neon yellow highlights. It is longer and has a fierce look. The end of its fin will be split and more spiky. Electric gets two arms and little legs. The fins are blade-like and it has spikes going down its spine. Its colors remain green with yellow highlights. It also has little wings, but cannot fly. Electros has a dragon man-like body with big wings that it now can use to fly. It has three claws on each hand and a bladed fin on its head. The spikes on its back emit electricity. The blade on the end of its tail can be used to suck up electricity as well as injecting it. I think this should give it an ability that lets it ignore the immunity against electric attacks of its opponent. Maybe even on top of that, doing 4 times damage to enemies that would normally only take 2 times damage. Don't know if that would be too uber, but it sounds cool. So, what do you think about these? Put your thoughts in the comments below, and maybe some of you even want to draw these? If enough people do, I might do a video where I will showcase your creations. With that, don't forget to razor leaf that subscribe button and thunder punch like. Bye-bye!